Good morning. Today we have to start a variable which may contain more than one values. Yet we have learned a lot that the variables are the facility in which the data are stored, by which the code which we generate for our purpose, they implement their processing. But whenever it is required that a variable more than one values should be considered as single name. For that very purpose, we have a facility in C programming language, and that is array. The characteristics of array, it means it may contain multiple values but of same data type. But of same data type, it means all the values should be of uniform mode. I mean, if the values are integer, then all should be integer. If they are in real, I will keep decimal. The value which contains decimal, that those are considered as real values. Like this, 3.25, 7.35, these are the real values. So, in C programming language, we have a facility of array in which we may store multiple values but of same data type, that is array. Now the question arises, how we will use the array in our programs? For that very purpose, as we know that all the variables which have to be used in the program, that should be declared first. So the array should be declared in a program like this manner. If the values are of integer type, then we declare it as int variable name, I mean array name, a double r int with a square bracket. That square bracket, the number of elements which are considered, which may contain in that particular array. Like here, if we have to store 5, if we have to store 5 values, then we will write here 5. This is the way by which we declare the array in our programs. Now, the next question, how these values will be stored in that particular array? For that very purpose, we use loops. Whatever the loop, you may use any of these which is suited for the purpose. Generally, we use the for loop. For loop is a loop in which we know in beginning that how many times the loop has to be executed. As it is determined that the 5 elements has to be stored in the array, so loop will be executed 5 times. So we use the loops to store a variable. Likewise, to read the value from the array, the loop is also used. Whatever, wherever, whenever the value will be required, we use respective loops and we get ready-made data from that array for our purpose. This is the array declaration and execution.